Let's continue with another session on mutual funds. In the previous session, we talked about certain basic parts, certain basics of mutual fund. We'll take the same discussion forward now. And now our focus will be on understanding the practical aspects of how do you invest, what kind of funds are available. Someone is asking me a question that what is the basic difference between ETF and MF? ETF is called as exchange traded funds, whereas MF is nothing but the mutual funds. The basic difference between the two is mutual funds are not traded on the stock exchanges. But the ETFs, that is the funds, the name itself suggests, those are being traded on the exchange. That's what is the basic difference between the two, wherein buying and selling can be done through the exchange. There is a separate exchange available for that. But anyways, now I'll try to focus upon the previous things first. We'll just try to recall what all we did in the previous session. And then I'll be bringing my focus on the different practical aspects. Yesterday, people had started talking about that what is SIP, in what way the SIP can be done. The people had started talking about certain specific funds. Now, what are these specific funds? What are these SIP concepts? Let's talk about that things one by one now. Just a moment. So in our previous session on the basics of mutual fund, we talked about what is mutual fund. We talked about that types of mutual funds, wherein I talked about that the mutual funds are basically the equity diversified mutual fund. There are debt oriented mutual fund where you are expected to have the fixed kind of return, a kind of liquid return. There are balanced funds, which has the feature of both the equity diversified as well as debt oriented mutual funds. Now, these mutual funds can be the open ended mutual fund, or it can also be the closed ended mutual fund. Open ended and closed ended. Now, what do I mean by open ended and closed ended? An open ended mutual fund is basically the one wherein you can invest at any point in time, you can withdraw at any point in time. That's why those are called as open ended. There is no restriction for the point of entry or the point of exit. Whereas in the case of closed-ended mutual fund, here the mutual fund, the board of directors of that AMC has already decided. We already talked about those concepts as well. If you remember, we had talked about AMC, we had talked about SEBI do the control on the mutual funds. So this closed-ended mutual fund are where the board of directors, that is the AMC or the asset management company, has decided that when you will stop taking the fresh investments into the mutual fund. That is what you call as the closed-ended, that they will be accepting the public deposits up to a particular point. Beyond that, they are not going to accept any of the things. Then we had also talked about what is NAV. We had also talked about the calculation of NAV, how the NAV is calculated. Maine aapko assets ka example bataya tha. NAV is basically the net asset value And how do we calculate that net asset value? Is the total value of assets less the expense ratio divided by the total number of units is what you call as the NAV or the net asset value of that particular unit. When you are making the investment in the new fund offer, this also we had talked about, NFO. When you want to make the investment in the new fund offer or the NFO, in that case, you are investing at the fresh value. That does not mean ki aapko ye bahut sasta mil raha hai. The new fund offer always comes with the same unit value. वो सस्ता है ऐसा नहीं है. उसके बाद में अगर फंड को नुकसान हो गया तो NAV बाद वाला कम होगा as compared to आज का जो वैल्यू है. Whereas अगर फंड ने सही जगह पे इन्वेस्टमेंट्स किए तो उनको ग्रोथ मिलेगी, उनको प्रॉफिट्स मिलेंगे एंड उस वजह से NAV बढ़ता रहता है. Today I'm going to show you some of the examples of the mutual funds. I'll be showing you some of the mutual funds where you can do the investments, and then we'll also talk about the concept of SIP. In fact, these days the people don't talk only about the SIP, they also talk about the SWP. आजकल के जमाने में आपको सिर्फ इन्वेस्टमेंट सिस्टमेटिक नहीं रखना होता है, हालांकि विड्रॉल भी सिस्टमेटिक करना होता है. आप रैंडम विड्रॉल करोगे आपके नुकसान होने वाले हैं. Whereas अगर आप विड्रॉल भी सिस्टमेटिक करोगे तो यू विल बी गेटिंग द बेनिफिट्स आउट ऑफ दैट. सो यू नीड टू हैव द सिस्टमेटिक इन्वेस्टमेंट प्लान एंड यू श्योरली बी हैविंग द सिस्टमेटिक विड्रॉल प्लान एज वेल. एंड दैट इज व्हाट वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट इन दिस सेशन ऑन the whole of the discussion related to the mutual funds, wherein we'll be talking about that how do you do the investments, what all kind of investments you can do, and the very important whether you should be starting to do the investment at this age. That's very much important. That's the doubt, that's the question with many of you. I'll be coming on to that practical aspect at a later point, but before that let me come to straight away the discussion on what is SIP and what is SWP. SIP is basically the systematic investment plan. Systematic investment plan. All right. Now just observe a simple story in here. Observe the simple case in here. I'll just present the live case in front of you. Let's go to this place called as moneycontrol.com. In this, if I go into the mutual fund section, within that, if I go into the kind of top ranked mutual funds. Now these are the top ranked mutual funds for last some time. If you would be making an observation, it will just come, just wait for a while, have patience. I just present this all in front of you, based on which it becomes more easier and simpler and clearer for us to understand the various things. Just a moment. Coming up, the screen share has basically got slowed down today. Yeah, what I did is I have searched this as the top ranked funds just for the sake of understanding. Aaj ye sare top ranked hai, matlab ye hamesha ke liye top ranked honge, aisa zaruri nahi hai. Just because they have performed in the recent past, they have made the consistent performance. And that's why they have been considered as the top ranked funds as at the point. There are the rankings which are given by the different authorities, different organizations, There are the rating agencies called as CRISIL, CARE, ICRA, etc. These all organizations do give the ranking to them, and based on that, this rank has come. It's a minute wording there. I'm just trying to elaborate it. Just wait for it. Here it is. I hope you're able to see this. Can you raise the hands for me if you're able to see this properly? Yeah, good, good, fine. Thank you. You can lower your hands, no problem. Now, observe it. And we are not talking about that which fund is good and which fund is bad. We are currently talking about that what are these funds and how do you make the investments in that. Basically, observe it. There is this fund which is given Axis Mid Cap Fund Direct Plan Growth. Ab ye kya hote hain? Mid cap, large cap, sectoral, non-sectoral, general. Ye sari cheeze main discuss karne wala hoon. Just wait for it. Because I said yesterday that ye jo humne pehle baat ki equity, debt and balance, ye primary category ho gayi. Usme kya hota hai? Aap kaan ke doctor ho. या आप एक डॉक्टर हो, फिर वो डॉक्टर में कौन सा वाला डॉक्टर? कान का डॉक्टर. कान वाले डॉक्टर में आप कौन से टाइप के कान की बीमारियां ठीक करते हो? कान को सुनाई नहीं देता है वो बीमारियां ठीक करते हो, कान में कचरा चले जाता है उसकी बीमारी ठीक करते हो, एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा. तो जैसे जैसे डिमांड बढ़ती है वैसे वैसे सप्लाई बढ़ता है, वैसे वैसे अलग अलग वेराइटी मार्केट में आने लग जाती है, एंड दैट्स वाई दिस वेराइटी इज अवेलेबल टू अस. तो इनके पास क्या है? नाउ इफ यू ऑब्जर्व द वेरी फर्स्ट एक्सिस मिड कैप फंड डायरेक्ट प्लान ग्रोथ. नाउ व्हाट इज दिस डायरेक्ट प्लान वेयर यू कैन मेक द इन्वेस्टमेंट डायरेक्टली इनटू द कंपनीज फंड्स. व्हाट इज द क्रिसिल रैंक फॉर देम इज 5 स्टार. फॉरगेट अबाउट दैट. वो कैसे आती है, क्या आती है, उसके पीछे बहुत बड़ी कहानी है. वी आर नॉट हियर टू थिंक अबाउट दैट. देयर असेट एंड नाउ दिस 5156.50 crore. This is the asset under management only for Axis Mid Cap Fund. ये पैसा Axis AMC का नहीं है कि Axis AMC पूरा इतना funds manage कर रही है, ऐसा नहीं है. सिर्फ Axis Mid Cap Fund के अंदर 5156.50 crore रुपए पड़े हैं, right? इतना पैसा वो roll over करते हैं, market में घुमाते हैं और उसपे से रिटर्न्स कमाते हैं, और वो रिटर्न्स अपने म्यूचुअल फंड यूनिट होल्डर्स को बांटते हैं. ऑलराइट, नाउ देयर रिटर्न्स इफ यू बी ऑब्जर्विंग फॉर लास्ट 1 month, दे हैव गिवन द अप्रोक्सीमेट रिटर्न ऑफ 9.03%. इन लास्ट 3 months दे हैव गिवन द रिटर्न्स ऑफ 16.95%. इन लास्ट 6 months दे हैव गिवन द रिटर्न ऑफ 3.35% नेगेटिव. मतलब वो लॉस में गए. अगर 6 महीने का कंपेयर, अगर आपने 3 महीने पहले इस कंपनी में इन्वेस्टमेंट किया होगा तो आपको 17% रिटर्न मिला होगा, और वही अगर आपने 6 महीने पहले इन्वेस्टमेंट किया होगा तो आपको 3.5% का नुकसान हुआ. क्यों? तो मार्केट उसके बाद बहुत टूटा था. इफ यू बी ऑब्जर्विंग, दीज आर सब्जेक्ट टू मार्केट रिस्क, प्लीज रीड द ऑफर डॉक्यूमेंट केयरफुली बिफोर इन्वेस्टिंग, इसीलिए कहा जाता है. हालांकि अगर आप इसका पूरे साल का कंपैरिजन करोगे, लास्ट 1 ईयर, प्रीवियस 1 ईयर का कंपैरिजन करोगे, तो दे हैव गिवन द रिटर्न ऑफ 5.26%, 2 साल में 6.44%. Annualized returns की बात कर रहे हैं हम लोग. साल दर साल जो रिटर्न होता है, last 3 years they have given the return of 10.357%, etc. Now make an observation, my dear friends. अगर मैंने इस कंपनी में, इस म्यूचुअल फंड में सिर्फ 3 महीने पहले एग्जैक्ट इतने, मान लो मैंने 10,000 रुपए इन्वेस्ट किए थे, कब? 6 महीने पहले. तो आज उस 10,000 रुपए की वैल्यू अपने आप 9,650 रुपए हो जाएगी, क्योंकि नुकसान हुआ है कंपनी को. पर अगर मैंने वही 10,000 रुपए 3 महीने पहले डाले होते तो आज मेरे असेट्स की वैल्यू होती 11,690 रुपए. क्यों? तो कंपनी ने रिटर्न दिया ना. और अगर मैंने 1 महीने पहले 10,000 रुपए इन्वेस्ट किए थे तो आई वुड हैव गॉट द टुडेज वैल्यू एज 10,903 रुपीज. माइंड वेल माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, दीज कंपनीज, दीज म्यूचुअल फंड्स विच आर इन्वेस्टिंग इन द मार्केट, योर फंड्स, ये आप जब पैसा दोगे उनके पास तब तब वो पैसा लगाते जाएंगे. और क्योंकि वो ऐसे मार्केट में डील कर रहे हैं जिसके वैल्यूज फ्लक्चुएट होते रहते हैं, तो उस फ्लक्चुएशन का फायदा हमें भी तो मिलना चाहिए या नहीं? एंड फॉर दैट पर्पस, ओनली फॉर दैट पर्पस, इट इज सेड, इट इज प्रपोज, इट इज सजेस्टेड दैट वन शुड डू द इन्वेस्टमेंट थ्रू द SIP रूट एंड नॉट थ्रू द डायरेक्ट और वन टाइम इन्वेस्टमेंट रूट. Whenever you want to make the investment into the mutual funds, it is always suggested that you should be doing the investment through the SIP route, that is the systematic investment plan route, and not that. So when I say that when you are doing the investment into the mutual funds, which are obviously subject to market risk, you are expected to do the investment through the SIP route. Now, why, when, how? Let's talk about that now. Just observe the case. मान लो हमने 6 महीने पहले इन्वेस्टमेंट किया, 6 months prior. We did the investment of 10,000. At that time, let's say NAV per unit, the net asset value per unit. The net asset value per unit at that point was, say, rupees 100. Just for the sake of understanding, I'm putting this board. In the factual situation, it will be different. All right? So, that means the number of units that I will be investing in is 100 units, correct? When I'm investing in 100 units, when I've got the NAV of 100, all right? Now, just imagine this as a situation, just observe this. Agar ये 100 यूनिट की वैल्यू सपोज 6 महीने बाद टुडे अगर इसका एनएवी 90 रुपए हो जाता है, 90 रुपीस एज ऑफ द डेट, टोटल नहीं, टुडे, इफ द एनएवी ऑफ दैट म्यूचुअल फंड बिकम्स 90 रुपीस, दैट मींस द वर्थ ऑफ 100 यूनिट्स विल बिकम 9,000 और नॉट. These 100 units will be multiplied with 90. मगर मतलब ये कि अगर आज मुझे ये 90, sorry, ये 100 यूनिट बेचने हैं तो मुझे 90 रुपए के हिसाब से बेचने पड़ेंगे. I'll be getting 9,000 rupees. That's it. Right? This is one time investment. अगर किया तो मान लो 6 month, 5 month, 4 month, 3 months, 2 month, 1 month. Today, this is prior. यहां मैंने इन्वेस्टमेंट की मान लो सिर्फ 2000 रुपए की, यहां 2000 रुपए और लगा दिए, यहां 2000 रुपए की और इन्वेस्टमेंट कर दी, यहां 2000 रुपए और लगा दिए. Then the value of investment is not changing. मैं कितने रुपए लगा रहा हूं वो बदल नहीं रहा. मान लो इसे भी हम लोग 12,000 पे लेके आते हैं. जस्ट फॉर द सेक ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग, हियर आई वुड बी गेटिंग 120 यूनिट्स. इफ द एनएवी टुडे इज 90, आई विल बी गेटिंग 10,800 रुपीस टुडे, करेक्ट? क्योंकि मैं 6 महीने 2,000 रुपए इन्वेस्टमेंट की बात कर रहा हूँ, इस वजह से. तो मैंने 6 अलग अलग महीनों में एक पर्टिकुलर तारीख पे 2,000 रुपए इन्वेस्ट किए. जब 6 महीना पहले इन्वेस्ट किया था तब एनएवी थी 100 रुपए, मार्केट पीक पे था, मार्केट अच्छा चल रहा था, 100 रुपए एनएवी बढ़ती जा रही थी, तो मुझे कितने यूनिट्स मिले? 20 यूनिट्स, करेक्ट? देन अब हुआ यूं कि मार्केट में और थोड़ी तेजी आ गई. अब तक कोरोना नहीं आया था, हमको पता चला चाइना में कोरोना आ गया, अमेरिका में कोरोना आ गया, अमेरिका बेहाल, चाइना बेहाल, हमारा देश एकदम खुशहाल. एंड इसलिए इसका एनएवी हो गया मान लो 120 रुपए, क्योंकि उन्होंने जहां इन्वेस्टमेंट कर रखा था वहां पे वैल्यूज बढ़ती जा रही थी तो इसका एनएवी बढ़ गया। तो 2000 रुपए जो मैंने लगा है उसको अगर 120 रुपए के हिसाब से बांटा जाए तो आई गॉट 16.67 यूनिट्स। सर फिर क्या फायदा हुआ, पिछली बार भी तो 16 सॉरी पिछली बार आपको यूनिट ज्यादा मिले थे, अब यूनिट कम मिले। अब समझ लो कि अब जनवरी आ गई, हमारे यहां कोरोना आ गया, राइट? जनवरी नहीं, इनफैक्ट मार्च आ गया, कोरोना आ गया हमारे देश में। और क्योंकि कोरोना आया, मार्केट एकदम बेहाल, मार्केट बदहाल, उसके एकदम सुस्त हाल, और मार्केट टूट के एनएवी हो गई 80 रुपए। अब मैंने जो 2000 रुपए लगाए उसका मुझे कितने के हिसाब से मिलेगा, 80 रुपए के हिसाब से कितने यूनिट्स मिलेंगे, 25 यूनिट्स, राइट? फिर और कोशिश की गई, लॉकडाउन कर दिया गया, लॉकडाउन किया तो मार्केट और बेहाल हुआ, इसका एनएवी हो गया 70 रुपए। सर इनका भी तो नुकसान हो रहा है, दैट्स व्हाई दे कीप ऑन सेइंग दैट दीज आर सब्जेक्ट टू मार्केट रिस्क, प्लीज रीड द ऑफर डॉक्यूमेंट केयरफुली बिफोर इन्वेस्टिंग, इजंट इट? तो 2000 रुपए में मुझे 70 रुपए के हिसाब से कितने यूनिट मिलेंगे, 28 यूनिट्स एंड 57 पैसे, करेक्ट? अब मार्केट में अप्रैल में लोगों को आदत पड़ गई, मई में अब लोग रिकवर करने लग गए और इनको लगा कि नहीं भाई कोरोना के साथ ही जीना है, और मार्केट रिकवर करने लगा क्योंकि लोगों ने, जापानीज कंपनीज ने अनाउंस कर दिया कि हम लोग चाइना छोड़ रहे हैं, अमेरिका वो कौन है हमारे ट्रंप साहब रोज वो शी जिनपिंग के नाम पे चिल्लाते रहते हैं, और हमारे देश का मार्केट भी रिकवर करना चालू कर दिया और अब उसकी वैल्यू हो गई 85 रुपीस एनएवी, जो उनके पास टोटल असेट्स हैं उसके हिसाब से एनएवी हो गई 85 रुपीस। अब क्योंकि एनएवी 85 रुपीस हो गई डिवाइड बाय 85, तो आई विल बी गेटिंग हाउ मेनी यूनिट्स, 23.53 यूनिट्स। एंड क्योंकि और मार्केट रिकवर हो गया जून में लगभग, तो अब इसकी एनएवी आ गई वापस से 95 रुपीस, राइट? तो 2000 के अगेंस्ट 95 रुपीस के हिसाब से आई गॉट 21.05 यूनिट्स। इसका मतलब ओवर द पीरियड ऑफ 6 मंथ्स आई गॉट इन ऑल हाउ मेनी यूनिट्स, 20 प्लस 16.67 प्लस 25 प्लस 28.57 प्लस 23.53 प्लस 21.05 इक्वल टू 134.82 यूनिट्स इन ऑल आई गॉट। आज की एनएवी कितनी, 90 रुपीस, हमने प्रीवियस एग्जाम्पल में देखा। दिस 134.82 विल बी मल्टीप्लाइड विथ 90 यूनिट्स एंड द वैल्यू ऑफ दैट टुडे इज 12,133.80। फ्रेंड दिस वॉज जस्ट एन इलस्ट्रेशन, दिस वॉज नॉट टू लूर यू पीपल, कई म्यूचुअल फंड्स में इन्वेस्टमेंट हमेशा सही होता है, ये सही होता है, इसमें नुकसान भी होता है, बट द पॉइंट इज व्हाट इफ यू आर अ लंबी रेस का घोड़ा और घोड़ी सॉरी गधा और गधी, आज जो आपके डिस्कशन चल रहे हैं उसके हिसाब से, तो अगर आप लंबी रेस के घोड़े हो और अगर आप लॉन्ग टर्म के लिए इन्वेस्टमेंट करना चाहते हो तो म्यूचुअल फंड्स इज वन ऑफ द फैंटास्टिक इन्वेस्टमेंट, इट ऑलवेज गिव्स यू द पॉजिटिव रिटर्न्स। व्हाई आई एम सेइंग दिस, now just make a simple observation on what I want to present in front of you. I won't take the top rated funds now, I'll just take the performance tracker. There is something called as BSP BlackRock's top 100 equity fund, this one, BSP top 100 equity fund. Now this is an advertisement. इनके असेट्स अंडर मैनेजमेंट है सिर्फ 2000 करोड़ रुपए, राइट? लास्ट वन वीक दे हैव गिवन द रिटर्न ऑफ 1.22%, लास्ट वन मंथ दे हैव गिवन द रिटर्न ऑफ 13.8%, लास्ट थ्री मंथ दे हैव गिवन द रिटर्न्स ऑफ 17.99%, एंड इफ यू टेक द कंपैरिजन, the mutual funds, even including the current scenario, are giving the returns for last so many years, which are in the positive territory. I'll just try to show you the mutual funds in the form of equity focused or equity mutual funds. If you just observe this, a small kind of list I'm trying to present in front of you. I'm not the agent with any of the mutual fund companies. Please remember this. Don't call me up for asking me ki kaun si mutual fund mein aap kitna investment karwa ke doge and all that. I'm not going to do that for you. I'm just presenting this for the sake of understanding, for the sake of knowledge, right? So that one should be able to understand. One should be able to know ki agar hame hamara liquid fund kahin invest karna ho, to usko kis tarah se kahan invest karna chahiye, right? I'll just try to search Reliance Equity Fund. Just a moment. It's not there. Reliance. These all are the institutional plans. Okay. Canara Robeco. Canara Robeco. Dynamic Bond. Canara Robeco. There are so many funds that this asset management company is running. These are there. Now, what is this? Equity Tax Saver Fund. Just observe this. These kind of things are not required by you, but just for the sake of understanding, I'm presenting it in front of you. Yes. If you can observe this, this fund got the inception on 30th September of 1998. This is the point when it started. If 10,000 is invested on the original date, the first date, that is 30th September 1998. जो मैं आपको कह रहा था कि लंबी रेस का घोड़ा कितना काम आ सकता है. The person would have invested on 30th September 1998 and would have survived with this mutual fund till date. The value of that would have become to 2,17,090 rupees. 98 से लेके अब तक अगर आपका इन्वेस्टमेंट इसमें कंटिन्यू हो गया होता, we are talking about a long duration, 22 years, you know. But in 22 years, that got converted 22 times. Isn't it? If you made the investment in 3 years earlier, that is on 23rd of June 2017, your investment of 10,000 would be today, as of the date, would be 11,418 rupees. If you would have invested in the month of January of 2020, today your value would have become 9,189. Why? Because of this pandemic situation. But if you would have invested on 26th of March 2020, 3 months prior, today your investment's value would have become 11,672 rupees. So they are giving you the fluctuating returns. They are giving you the returns which are changing from point to point. And therefore it is understood, therefore it is observed that you should have the investment in the sequential form so that you will always keep getting the benefit of averaging of the prices. And when you start getting that benefit of averaging of the prices, you automatically have the better performance over the longer period of time. If you just make an observation here, कि अगर आपने 6 महीने पहले इस कंपनी में इन्वेस्ट किया, इस म्यूचुअल फंड में इन्वेस्टमेंट किया था, तो उस समय पे इस म्यूचुअल फंड की वैल्यू जो थी वो 11th रैंक थी अमंग्स द गिवन कैटेगरी. सो दिस इज व्हाट यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड, दैट व्हेन यू आर मेकिंग द इन्वेस्टमेंट ऑन अ सिस्टमेटिक बेसिस, एक तो आपको डिसिप्लिन लगता है इन्वेस्टमेंट करने का, यू ऑटोमेटिकली गेट डिसिप्लिन फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट, एंड टू you get the benefit of averaging also, and that's why it is always suggestible that one should go for the systematic investment plan. Is it right? Whether you should make the investment every month, whether you should make the investment every 3 months, that's all up to you. That all depends on your investment appetite. But the SIPs normally come in the form of monthly investments only. SIPs do not come on the annualized basis or on a quarterly basis. SIP agar aapko karna hai, toh wo monthly investment ke hisab se hi hota hai. Now there are the investment returns. Yahan pe inhone already calculate karke rakhe hue hain. Jis vyakti ne 1000 rupees har mahine pichli June se lagaye hue hain, June 2019 se, that person is at loss at this point in time. Why? Because the market went down. But jis vyakti ne 2 saal pehle se paisa laga ke rakha hai, to usko sirf 1% ka nuksan hua hai, but paisa intact hai. Jis vyakti ne 3 saal pehle se paise lagaye hain, they have got the return of 1%, profit hua hai. And the person who have been doing the investment for last 10 years on a consistent basis of only rupees 1000 per month, only 1000 per month over the period of 10 years, that is for 120 months, he must have done the investment of 120,000. Today, his value has become 1,94,276. Understand the benefits further, my dear friends. Ek, we get discipline. Two, you automatically start accumulating the corpus for you. And three, you get the benefit of averaging. Four, you get the returns which are more than any other fixed deposit will give. And five, majority of the time, these are the tax benefits. Or these are the tax-free kind of incomes. Yahan pe 9.31% ka return hai, agar aapne 10 saal tak ke continuous investment kiya tha, 9.31% koi bhi fixed deposit nahi deta hai. Yeah, this will keep fluctuating, but does not mean that you will be at loss. You will generally be at profit when it comes to the returns. Well, anyways, so that's the benefit of making the investment through the SIP route. My last part of discussion today is, in this session, is only to know that what variety of mutual funds are available in the market. In fact, friends, आजकल इतना वैरायटी है मार्केट में अवेलेबल कि आप यू नेम अ सेक्टर एंड यू हैव गॉट द म्यूचुअल फंड फॉर दैट. म्यूचुअल फंड वैरायटी ओनली आई विल नॉट राइट द टाइप्स, बिकॉज़ टाइप्स आर ओनली 3 or 4, दैट इज बॉन्ड इन्वेस्टेड, द डेट म्यूचुअल फंड्स, इक्विटी म्यूचुअल फंड्स एंड द बैलेंस्ड, दैट्स इट. शॉर्ट टर्म के लिए होते हैं, लॉन्ग टर्म के लिए होते हैं, इक्विटी होते हैं और उसके बाद में बैलेंस्ड होते हैं. दीज आर द बेसिक कैटेगरीज. उसी के अंदर क्लोज एंडेड, ओपन एंडेड, इक्विटी म्यूचुअल फंड्स आर जनरली ओपन एंडेड, द मनी मार्केट लिंक्ड आर जनरली ओपन एंडेड, डेट म्यूचुअल फंड्स समटाइम्स आर क्लोज एंडेड, बैलेंस फंड्स आर ऑल्सो जनरली द क्लोज एंडेड. बट वैरायटी फॉर टैक्स सेविंग, देर आर द म्यूचुअल फंड्स अवेलेबल फॉर द टैक्स सेविंग ऑल्सो. We call this as ELSS, Equity Linked Savings Schemes. Please understand, this is different from the ULIPs, Unit Linked Insurance Plans. Wo ULIPs jo hote hain, wo insurance company bechti hai. Agle kuch dinon ke baad mein hum log insurance pe bhi charcha karne wale hain. The insurance in the form of, say, mediclaim, or the insurance in the form of life insurance. Ye sari cheeze discuss karenge hum log. Kaun sa sahi hota hai, kaun sa गलत होता है, ये हम लोग डिस्कस करेंगे, वेट फॉर इट. देन द अदर वेराइटी इज सेक्टोरल. When your mutual fund is making the investment into a particular sector of the market, they are not taking the exposure in all the sectors, then you will be having the based on capex or based on capital. I won't write this as capex, I will write this as based on capital, the market cap. Considering market cap. Now, what is this market cap? It is the market capitalized value of a particular company's shares. Market capitalized मतलब क्या? उस company के total number of shares multiplied by उसका आज का market price. That is what we call as market cap. All right. Now, tax saving ELSS are where investment. Is tax free. That means अगर आपने ELSS में invest किया तो आपको उसका income tax में फायदा मिलता है. किस तरह से उसके बारे में चर्चा नहीं करूंगा, foundation के खर्चे में intermediate नहीं पढ़ाऊंगा. Right? Then the another benefit of tax saving mutual funds or ELSS in the link equity link saving schemes. The second feature of this is there is a lock-in involved into this. Whenever you make the investment in the tax-saver mutual funds, in that case, you will be having a lock-in of a minimum period of 3 years from the date of investment. So, agar aap SIP mode mein kar rahe ho, to pehla wala SIP 3 saal ke liye, agla wala SIP us din se 3 saal ke liye. Pehle SIP ki date se 3 saal nahi. हर SIP की डेट से 3-3 साल का लॉक इन अप्लाई होता रहेगा, राइट? एंड इन मेजॉरिटी ऑफ द केसेस इवन द विड्रॉल्स आर आल्सो टैक्स फ्री. जनरली इट इज ऑब्जर्व दैट द टैक्स फ्री म्यूचुअल फंड्स गिव यू द बेटर रिटर्न्स बिकॉज देयर इज अ लॉक इन इन्वॉल्व. तो ये पैसा उनके पास, मतलब फंड ओनर जो होता है, फंड मैनेजर जो होता है, उसके पास ये पैसा ज्यादा देर के लिए होता है फॉर प्लेइंग इट अराउंड, फॉर जस्ट मेकिंग द इन्वेस्टमेंट्स, एंड देयरफॉर दीज म्यूचुअल फंड्स जनरली गिव द हायर रिटर्न्स. बट द पॉइंट इज वेरी क्रिटिकल दैट देयर इज अ लॉक इन, यू विल नॉट बी अलाउड टू विथड्रॉ इट, यू विल नॉट बी अलाउड टू टेक द लोन अगेंस्ट दैट, राइट? देन व्हाट आर द सेक्टोरल म्यूचुअल फंड्स? सेक्टोरल म्यूचुअल फंड्स आर बेस्ड ऑन द पर्टिकुलर सेक्टर, ऑन पर्टिकुलर business sector when the investment is done, that is called as sectoral mutual fund. Now within this, based on particular business sector, you will be having single sector or you'll be having multiple sectors. What is single sector? Agar suppose koi kehta hai ki banking mutual fund, तो उसका इन्वेस्टमेंट एरिया वो सिर्फ बैंकिंग कंपनी के शेयर्स में रहेगा. आईटी म्यूचुअल फंड, तो दैट कंपनी, दैट म्यूचुअल फंड विल बी इन्वेस्टिंग ओनली इन द आईटी रिलेटेड कंपनीज. आईटी और आईटीईएस, आईटी मींस इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी एंड आईटीईएस इज इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी एनेबल्ड सर्विसेज. सो दैट्स हाउ दैट पर्टिकुलर इन्वेस्टमेंट विल बी डन. सो why this lock in is basically for you are being given the benefit in the taxes, that's why there is a lock in. So that is sector based investment. In fact, I generally don't suggest people to make the investment into a particular sector unless and until there is a kind of clear cut agenda with the organization, with the institution, based on which they will be making the investments. Then market cap, isme alag alag type ki companies hoti hai jisko स्टॉक एक्सचेंज डिवाइड करता है, स्मॉल कैप, मिड कैप एंड लार्ज कैप. द डेफिनेशन फॉर दिस कीप ऑन चेंजिंग फ्रॉम पॉइंट टू पॉइंट. आई जस्ट प्रेजेंट बिफोर यू व्हाट इज अ लार्ज कैप, व्हाट इज अ मिड कैप. मिड कैप कंपनीज, definition. Definition of small cap, large cap, and mid cap. This is identified by the SEBI only. Yeah. Large cap is where the company's total market capitalization, matlab market price per share multiplied by their number of shares. If that particular thing is above 10,000 crore, then in that case it becomes the large cap company. Agar us company ka market capitalization 2000 se 10,000 crore ka hai, then in that case it will be called as a mid cap company. And if it is below 2000 crore, it will be called as a small cap company. The small capital company, that's what we call as the small cap company. So this is how that division is done. So agar company ne decide kiya, mutual fund ne decide kiya that they will be doing the investment only in the small caps, they'll be focusing only on the small cap. Kyun? So investment value kam ho jati hai, return milne ke chances badh jate hain. There are certain companies which are interested to do the investment in the large cap funds, wherein the large caps, because they are fundamentally very strong organizations, and as these are very fundamentally very strong organizations, therefore people would tend to invest in these kind of organizations to get the better returns. So I don't suggest any kind of sectoral investment. Generally it is suggested that one should do the investment in the multi-diversified mutual funds, wherein it is always expected to get the better returns as compared to a particular sectoral investment or as compared to a particular capitalization based. However, there are the people who have got the specific agenda of focusing only on the particular sector, and in that case they can go for the sectoral or the capital based investments, right? So mutual fund sahi hai if you do it for the longer term. If you do it through the SIP route, you'll always be getting the returns through that, right? So that's it from me for the day. If you have any kind of questions, you can keep posting me those questions and we'll be answering it whensoever the situation comes. Do we have information regarding where our mutual fund is invested? Absolutely. They give you 100% detail. There is a 100%, 110% transparency, I would say, wherein they would provide you that which all companies they have made the investments in, and that they keep on publishing in the open source. But small cap may return kam hoga. Not necessarily, because there are the companies which get converted from small cap to large cap very fast. So in those cases, you will surely be having the better returns from them. Such system will be there daily. In some cases, the registrars provide you this kind of information daily, whereas in some cases, it is not available on a daily basis. It will be available on weekly or monthly basis. They themselves keep sending this all information to their unit holders. Can we invest at the present age? Oh, you can start your investment only after the age of 18. At this point in time, if you want to, in that case, you will be required to do under the guidance of your parents only. You can start the investment, but with the signature of your parents. Of course, I'm going to do that. Yeah, right away after this lecture, I'll be doing the uploading of this session. 63 companies in BSE. So can we invest only in that companies? Who said that there are only 63 companies? There are so many of those. Please go, try to have some more research. Okay. As far as my session attendance is concerned, for this whole week, you need not register daily. That is for the whole week. For the next week, you'll be required to register again. Do we have to create a new account in the bank for mutual fund SIP? No, not at all. Does it require any account for investing in mutual fund? No, you can directly do the investment. Even if you don't have the DMAT account, you can start doing the investment. What is entry and exit load? entry load and exit load is basically the charges which are levied by the mutual fund if you are making the investment after a particular point in time. Currently, in fact, entry load concept is gone. There is only exit load. Exit load is when you withdraw the money within a pre-specified period of time. Aaj aapne investment kiya, 3 mahine baad agar aap withdraw kar rahe ho, to aapko uski bharpai karni hoti hai, and that is exit load. These all are controlled by the SEBI. These all are not decided by the companies themselves. Which is the best site to start a search on basics from account according to you? Currently, I would say there are a number of sites available. You can go through ZBusiness, you can go through Money Control, and you'll be getting a lot of information when it comes to the business ratio or business thing. Expense ratio, kali maine bataya tha previous session mein. Expense ratio is basically the amount of expenses that the company is going to incur as decided, controlled by the SEBI. Minimum amount of investment in some companies, it is only 500 rupees. In some companies, it is 1000 or 5000 rupees. So it depends from company to company. No need to read any book on investments. You will keep getting the information. I would love to take the questions, but you have already got the session. So I'll just stop the discussions here. Any further questions on WhatsApp? Thank you. Thank you very much.